and the world's only accredited spectress. And the journey we shall go on tonight is not for the faint of heart. You have been warned. My assistants have collected items from random members of our audience and presented them to me. Through the lost art of psychometry, I shall pull from these objects memories, fragments of their previous owners. I shall delve into the world of shadows, spirits, specters, and a man, an old man, Marcus. His name is Marcus. Are you here tonight, Marcus? Marcus, is this your cigarette case? Ring once for yes, twice for no. Good, good. Contact has been established. I sense great sadness, a profound sorrow. A young woman, happy and in love. Your wife, Marcus, your bride of many years, who remains among the living, is she here tonight in the audience? Oh, yes, yes. You there! Your husband, Marcus, is here with us. He wishes to, wait. He's stuck in the netherworld between this realm and the next, and he wishes to speak to you one last time. Is that right, Marcus? Very well. I shall now place myself into a hypnagogic trance, a technique I learned from the Bolkhor priest. Allow me a moment. I speak from this world to the next. I speak from this world to the next. I speak from this world to the I speak from this world to the next. Wait! Something's wrong! There's a... Oh my God! There's a ghost! Someone help! Please! Call the gym nurse! Call the doctor! Call someone! I don't believe it. Sweet mercy of Christ, it worked. It actually worked. I must apologize to the poor deluded nincompoops in the office. But Marcus won't be joining us tonight. Not that he was actually ever here. Want to know how old Devane was able to pull off that trick? Oh, let me go, you terror! It's quite simple, really. Weeks leading up to the performance, Anton formed the obituaries for wealthy corpses. Corpses for grieving relatives. Relatives who could afford to pitch tickets to our show. You see, Anton was a private investigator in another life, so he dug up whatever facts he couldn't memorize. And then he had our assistants, Be on the lookout. You, madam. Marcus is with him. We didn't choose your cigarette case by chance. Oh my God! Please! Somebody! Help me! Help me! He was just about to switch into this big old man and start blabbering out a few sentimental generalities. He was a hatchet. Black sheep eating like that. What he wasn't counting on was me. Emil Gaspar. Actress. Oh my God! Call the priest! This isn't a hoax! I couldn't disappoint my devoted fans. You wanted to see Gaspar in vain. So here we are, in one body. Want to know how Marcus was able to respond? Anton tied a string to the bell's clap, and from underneath the table, he would just ooh. It was all chicanery, ladies and gentlemen. Small and meaningless, sleight of hand, good old-fashioned bullshit to me. What in God's name are you doing, Kasparov? Well, it's quite simple, my dear Devane. I'm ruining you. It seems only right and fair, considering you've been poisoning me for the last 6 months. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. The untimely illness that took my life this morning was far from rapid. My soul is shit-healed of a part that had been slipping the tiniest bits of arsenic in my teeth. Slowly but surely, it became more and more sick. And just as I realized my own mortality, Anton played his final card. You see, Emil Castro had no family and only one friend, so it seemed only sensible that I would leave my not insubstantial winnings to my one dear friend.